Hi everyone, welcome to this video on how to get started with the Blazor button component of Syncfusion. In this video, I will show you how to use the Blazor button component with its built-in features such as showing icons on button, adding some predefined styles to it and different button types. Also, I will explain you how easily you can bind the click event to a button component. To explore the other features available in the Syncfusion Blazor button, refer to the website link shown in the above YouTube card. Now, I will proceed to show you how to add the button component to a Blazor server app using Visual Studio 2019. Before I start to create the Blazor application, first I need to make sure whether .NET Core SDK latest version is installed in my machine and I should have Visual Studio Code or Visual Studio 2019 to create a Blazor application. In this tutorial, I'm going to create a new server-side Blazor app. So, let me open the Visual Studio 2019 first and create a new project from the dashboard. From the list of project templates, I will choose Blazor app and click Next to proceed further with the project creation. Here, I will name my project as Blazor example and click the Create button. Next, I will choose this Blazor server app option and click this Create button finally to complete the project creation. Now, the project has been created and ready to use. If you want to know more about the Blazor server app and how to add Syncfusion components to it, then you can listen to the video link that is shown in the above YouTube card. Now, I will tell you the steps to add the Blazor button component. Before I start to use the Syncfusion Blazor button component, first I need to install the Syncfusion Blazor NuGet package into my application. For that, I will open the NuGet package manager by right-clicking the project and choose the option Manage NuGet packages. Then, I will search for Syncfusion Blazor in the Browse tab and install it into my project. Once the installation gets completed, let me navigate to imports.razor file and here I will add Syncfusion Blazor buttons namespace to start using the Blazor button in any of the components available under the pages folder. Next, I will open the startup.cs file and here I will add Syncfusion Blazor namespace. Then, I will register the Syncfusion Blazor service by calling a method addSyncfusionBlazor within the configureServices method. Also, I should register the valid license key into my application. So, let me register the trial license key using the registerLicense method. The next important thing is I need to define the CSS for button component. Therefore, let me navigate to host.cshtml file under the pages folder to refer the CSS file from the installed Syncfusion Blazor package. Now, everything is configured, so let me start to add the Blazor button component. For that, I need to open the index.razor component and here I will remove the default code and include button component. Then, I need to add content for the button. So, let me define a variable button content and assign the value play to it. Now, I will assign this variable button content to the content property of the button component. Next, let me save and run this example. So here, you can see the output page. The button component is rendered with the text play. Now, I will proceed to show you how to apply built-in predefined styles to button component. The available predefined button styles are primary, success, informative, warning, danger, and link. From these button styles, I'm going to create a primary button. So, within this Blazor button code, let me define a property CSS class and assign predefined class ePrimary to it. See the output page now the button component is displayed with primary button style. Next, I will proceed to explain about the available Blazor button types. The available Blazor button types are flat button, outline button, round button, and toggle button. Here, I have planned to apply a border for the button with a transparent background. So, let me add predefined class eOutline to the CSS class property of button component. Look at the output page now. The button component is rendered with a transparent background and border. Suppose, if I want to add an icon for the button, then I may need to make use of the property icon CSS. To add an icon, I will define the property icon CSS and set appropriate class names to it. Now, within the style section, I will define a font face with a specific source path and name, its font family as button icons, to start accessing the play icon for this button component at the application level. Then, to this class name assigned to the icon CSS property, I will now assign the appropriate content value to access the play icon. See the output page now. The button is displayed with the play icon. Here, you can notice that the icon is placed at the left side of the button content. Suppose, if I want to change the position either at the right, top, or bottom of the button content, then I may need to use the property icon position. Now, I'm going to change the icon position as right. So, let me define the property icon position and set its position as right. Look at the output page now. The icon is placed at right side of the button content. Similarly, you can also display the button icon at top or bottom of the button content by changing their position. Now, I will show you how to toggle the button state. To toggle the button state, I will define the property isToggle and set its value as true within this Blazor button code. And now, you can see the button component. The button is active in toggled state. Next, I will proceed to show you how to add click event for the button. To make it clear, let me retain the content property and remove all other properties from the Blazor button code. Here, I'm going to change the button content while clicking the button. For that, first I need to define the native event onClick with an appropriate event handler. Now, I will define the event handler change button content within this code block. Then, I need to change the button content. Therefore, I will assign the value passed to the variable button content. So here, you can see the button component. When I click the button, the content is changed to pass. Apart from onClick event, the Syncfusion Blazor button also supports other native events like onBlur, onFocus, onFocusOut, and so on. Finally, I will proceed to show you how to disable the Blazor button component. To disable Blazor button component, let me define the property disabled and set its value as true. See the output page now. The button component is in disabled state. Now, let me make a quick summary of what we have seen so far. We have seen how to create a Blazor project using Visual Studio 2019 and added a Syncfusion Blazor button component in a server app. Also, we have seen how to change the default button style as well as how to toggle the button state. Finally, we have also seen how to set an icon for button component and how to add click event to it. If you would like to see the working of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link, which I have shared in the description part below. You can also grab your chance of getting a free license key to use a complete Blazor products if you fit into a community license guidelines. So, check the link given in the description part to know if you're eligible for using a community license. Also, if you find this video as useful, Don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching this video.